Well, good morning, folks. Good to be with you this morning on September 19th. Let me draw some attention to some of the things that are happening here in the life of the church. We have soup ingredients that are needed. If you look outside, you will see some of the, there's a sign-up sheet with some of the ingredients that need to be collected. There's also a sign-up sheet for Safe Sanctuary, if you need to be trained in that as well. We could use you to sign up for that, as that's right out there too. There is also Grow Kids tonight for the kids and youth group at 6. Both of those start at 6. Is there any other announcements that we need to draw attention to this morning? Well, let's begin our worship then in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. One of the things that was requested by some of the folks here was a replay of the video that we showed for the kids that we showed last week, and we're going to start off our worship today by showing that. So take a look at this. Well, if you're able to today, stand as we join together with our call to worship. We come to hear the story of God's faithfulness to past generations. The God who was with our ancestors is with us as well. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Praise be to God. Let's join together with our opening hymn, A Mighty Fortress is Our God. Thank you. I have something with me today. You may be seated. I brought something with me. I don't know. Has anybody ever been to a place called Benazet? Yeah, and you see the elk there? I got this down at Benazet. One of the things that's beautiful about living in Western Pennsylvania, where we do, we get to see these things, don't we? How many of you guys have seen an eagle flying around? Yeah. Where I was living before, down in Franklin, they had these wonderful bike paths, and I got to see them quite a bit. And one of the things that's wonderful about eagles is that they have these huge wings that are really, really strong. And Scripture tells us that one of the things that we can do is put our faith in God, our hope in God, and we will rise up on wings like eagles, and we will not grow weary because we have our faith in God. And so as we think about eagles, one of the things that we should think about is the strength that God provides us when we rely on Him. So let's continue to think about that, because we're going to be looking at that scripture passage this morning, and we are going to look and see where we can draw our strength from and how we put our faith in God. So let's take some time to pray. Lord God, we thank You for this time that we can celebrate. We thank You for this time that we can cherish who You are. We thank You for the strength that You give us. And we pray this simply in Your name. Amen. So the scripture passage that we are looking at this morning is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, found in the Old Testament, verses 28 through 31. Goes along with the eagle thing. So it says, the book of Isaiah, Isaiah said, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and His understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fail. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. And if you would grant me 2 minutes, I will be right back. Thank you. Folks, we need hope, don't we? I probably don't need to tell you that this morning. I could list the things that are robbing us from hope, and you could say, I know. And I don't want to be a person of gloom, despair, and agony on me, but simply said, we know that we need hope. We need a new thing. Our politics lead us to places of despair and division that many of us have not seen before, have we not? It seems lately, too, that the church is experiencing a lot of illness and loss. There have been strokes and falls, death and cancer, surgeries. Hope is needed. Hope is needed, and I'm already going down that road of negativity. If we look at the world that we live in, we know that there is a need of hope. We watch the news, and you know, I don't know if you're like this, I am, but sometimes we have to turn it off because of the lack of hope. But I want to remind you something today. That is just one way to look at things. One perspective, there is another perspective that we could take. For do you not know? Have you not heard? You know, it is interesting that maybe you have not heard before. Maybe you haven't heard. But even those of us who have heard, we can lose that hope in an instant. Sometimes we can read a great passage of Scripture and be filled with God's help. Hope, and then we have a squirrel moment, right? And then it is gone. It is dashed. The voice of God has become diminished, if it were there at all sometimes. It is like this. I am God. Can you hear me? Hello? Is this thing on? Is there anybody back there? You know, it might seem silly, but maybe it's like that. It's serious. What are the voices that we have let into our lives? What are the voices that we have let speak loudly into our lives? You know, one of the voices that have been very loud is the voice of politics. Have our politics become too loud? You know, I have seen people leave a church because they are listening more to politics than they are to the voice of God. You may have seen that too. Our media has spoken louder. And you know what? It is hard, and I've been in many discussions, and it's very hard to tell if media is dictating to us how we should live, or does society dictate to media what to present. It is hard to know. The voices of our movies, TV shows, podcasts, or even social media have become louder, and they become louder and louder and louder. Hello? Maybe this isn't on. Is this on? Yeah. We need hope. Do you not know? Have you not heard? You know, our God is the everlasting God, our Creator. You know, and this is another problem that we have, folks, is what is our definition of God? That is why the other voices may have become louder. You know, in the 60s, the 1960s, way back in the day, culture was very blunt. They said that God was dead. But today, it is much more subtle. When we let the other voices, though, become louder in our lives, we're pretty much doing the same thing. We're pretty much saying the same thing. When we let the other voices become louder in our lives, He is Creator. And as we look at science in our world, we tend to do two different things sometimes. You know? We do two extremes.
Some of us have let science have a bigger voice. And that lets us separate ourselves from God. And some of us don't believe what science is saying at all, ignoring the proofs and using what we call our beliefs, not to believe what is out there. What if we looked at both? Have you ever thought about that? That maybe science is how God chooses to work. And some of the claims that are happening in our society that are happening somewhat of our brokenness and how we choose to use God's creation. Now, I would really agree with you that there is a movement out there in science that seems to be somewhat anti-God. And again, we can't let science have the bigger voice. But we cannot be ignorant as well. God does not grow tired or weary, too. Did you see that in the scripture passage? He is 7-11. We have seen many places that were once 7-11 not be so much anymore since this pandemic has hit. Maybe it's because of the pandemic, or maybe it's because it can't get employees. I don't know. But it does show our human frailty, does it not? Well, one of the things that I tell people a lot of times, and I tell you this morning, you can call me. If you have my cell phone number, and I'd be glad to give it to you, you can call me 24 hours a day, day or night. But the truth of the matter is, I am human and eventually going to tire out and sleep, and there's going to be some time that you're going to call me, especially like if it's 3:00 in the morning, that I'm not going to be altogether there. You know, none of us can be there 24/7. But God does not grow tired or weary. The internet, we would say too, is, you might argue with me, is 24/7 too. But the understanding is always somebody else's failed understanding. Now, you may have some people that you know that have great insight. There are some great people that I believe are truly mouthpiece for God. Maybe we could call them modern day prophets. But God is the one we should be listening to. And when we hear other people talk, is it matching up to the Word of God? We will never be able to understand the fullness of everything. And we will never be able to understand God completely in our finite state of being. But that doesn't mean that we should ever leave our faith. We should cling to the one whose understanding is far greater than ours. Even youth, folks, I don't know if you watch them and have all so much energy, they grow tired and weary. I know when I see kids running around, the little kids, I don't know if you say this too, I think, I would surely like that energy that they have. But that same kid who is running around like the Energizer Bunny is lying on the floor seconds later in a heap, and we cart them off to bed. Have you ever seen that happen before? Probably. So, the question this morning when we think about strength and endurance, what is the voice that speaks loudest into your life? Think about it. Maybe look at it this week. Because that voice is probably showing you where you get your strength from, or possibly how you're losing your strength. You know, a lot of people that the author, the prophet Isaiah was speaking to or writing to in the original text, if you know anything about the history of that book, he was writing to people who were in captivity. He wanted to remind them in their captivity where they got their strength from. In reality, folks, if we think about it, we are in captivity today, held in bondage with our political ideologies, our culture. We are held captive by the false prophets that we let speak into our lives. Some of us are physically held captive in our bodies with sickness. And there are such things too as trafficking or pornography. And I don't have to tell you that the global pandemic has held us captive, and we are so over it and tired. But let me, like the prophet Isaiah, tell you of a new hope. And I am not talking about a Star Wars movie here. For this hope should be new every day. God will renew our strength, and we will be like wings, like eagles. Have you ever seen an eagle? We talked about that. A lot of you raised your hands. And when I lived in Franklin, I saw them a lot. And once when I was riding on the bike path, I was riding about 7 o'clock at night. One came flying right at me on eye level and went right past me. And I got to see the majestic, the beautiful being that it was. And I have seen them swoop down and pick up a fish out of French Creek. Something beautiful to see. And you know what? I found out they are honking big. And I would not want to mess around with one. Their wings are massive and strong. And this is what God promises. But it doesn't just happen, folks. It is contingent on us and our willingness to submit. Are we willing? Are we willing? And it is not just some of our lives. You know, God, Jesus brought grace, and salvation is free. But the strength, God wants to affect our whole life. We need to give the whole life to God. Many of us will let God transform the easy parts. Like, I can give God an hour on Sunday morning. But what if we gave God our all? That in every area of our life that we could soar. Soar like eagles. Doesn't sound so bad, does it? So why don't we do it? Well, just a guess. This is what I'm thinking this morning. We have turned the volume of the other things up and turned the volume down on God. Something to think about. Maybe, again, that is something that you could look at in your week. What are the voices in your life? What is the loudest voice in your life? It may be robbing you of the hope that we are talking about today. It may be holding us back. We may not be the people that we could be. We may not be the church that we could be. You know, we need to start talking about this with one another. What is robbing us of this hope? How this hope needs to be communicated to our community. Because if we don't communicate this hope to our community, we are robbing our community, our world. Our world is in need of hope, is it not? And I believe that we are robbing this world of hope. And you know what? One of the commandments that I read in the book of Exodus is, thou shalt not steal. Are we stealing from our community by not communicating this hope? So let's start looking, folks. What are we listening to? For, do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Let's go forth with this truth. Amen. Let's join together with our praise hymn this morning. It is well with our soul. Thank you. may be seated. Let's take some time this morning to thank God about how He's provided so that we can do His kingdom work. And let me remind you that our offering plates are by the doors if you feel called to partake in our offering this morning. But let's lift up some praises to God for how He has provided. This morning, you may be seated. Is there anything that we need to be lifting up in prayer? April, please. Oh, April, I'm so sorry. A cousin that has gone too soon. We pray for your family as they go through this. Many families go through that. We'll pray for April and her family. Any other things to be praying for? Lynn, you have surgery tomorrow.
Wednesday.
Shoulder surgery. We could be praying for you. Absolutely. You had a wedding last weekend. There you go. There you go. Some things to praise God for and to pray for. Absolutely. Any other things to be lifting up? Amber. Okay. We'll be praying for that family, lost somebody. And it's been a series of losses. Some folks can echo that and know what that's like to go through. So definitely be praying for that for you guys. Anything else? Jane. It's great to have you guys here. And you're all the way from Phoenix? Wow, cool. Good to have you guys here. What's that?
2 weeks.
For 2 weeks. There you go. Welcome.
It was a surprise
visit. A surprise visit. Oh, that's great. That's great. Well, welcome to the great, we can't say white right now, praise God, but great north. So let's take some time to pray. Lord God, we thank you for this time that we can gather. We pray for those who are not able to gather with us, and we thank you for the opportunity to worship from home. We pray for these things, Lord, that were mentioned. And Lord, we lift ourselves up to you as you are Father Almighty, Creator of the world. We thank you for who you are, and we thank you for Jesus and how he brings us back. For Lord, we have wandered, we have strayed, and we ask for your forgiveness. Lord, please forgive us when we sin in our life and when we are distracted. And Lord, I ask that whatever said here today would be from your word. And Lord, we ask for forgiveness for things that may not be. Help us to forget those things and help us to remember your word and your truth. Lord, we just also ask that you would continue to guide us to be the people of God, people of strength. And Lord, as we pray these things, we have some things on our hearts this morning too. I want to pray for April and her family as they are dealing with a sudden loss. For Amber's family, as well as they are dealing with a loss of an aunt, we lift them up, especially with a series of losses. We celebrate, God, that there are new people in our families, like through a marriage, and we pray for surgeries. We lift up Lynn, and we pray for people who are recovering, like Nancy Joe, and for Karen Ulmer, and for Lois Canfield. Lord, we lift those folks up to you. And we have joy today too, Lord, with people visiting, even through a surprise. And Lord, we thank you so much for family and for what they mean for us. And Lord, as we pray today, I pray that we would have the strength by looking at who you are, that we would not be distracted by the things of the world, but that we would be focused on your strength and that we would endure. Lord, I have to confess and I have to lay my heart down and say that I have been distracted in ways. And Lord, we just pray that you would continue to remind us of this great scripture that shows us that where our strength comes from, and it's from you. Lord, we want to thank you too for Jesus, who showed us how to live, showed us many things. And one of the things he showed us was on how to connect with you, and we We pray that prayer this morning saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. So let's join together with our closing hymn this morning, number 364, Because He Lives. Pretty distracted world where the voices become louder and louder and louder, don't we? I've told you that already a couple times today, but you know, it's very true. And I pray that that you'll go forth today with the voice of God reigning in your heart, that the grace of Christ would be prevalent in how you live, and the work of the Holy Spirit would continue to do a work within and through you. Let's go forth in peace. Amen.